Yes, good morning to all the students. We are going to continue this chapter from page number 29. Yesterday I just introduced only the Happy Prince, and based on the theme of social injustice means social inequality, fine, when all the segments of the society, they are not treated equally, that is called social injustice. There are many, you know, mini stories in this story. We will be meeting many new characters. We will be having feeling of empathy towards them. We will sympathize with them ki kitna unka bura haal hai. In society, there are many people who are suffering. And you know, this chapter is actually a transition of Happy Prince. When he was alive, he was very happy because he used to live within the four walls of royal family where every facility was there. He was getting all the luxurious life, you can say luxurious items in his house. He did not know what being sad is. So when he became a statue, and when his statue was erected at a highest pedestal in the town, then he started seeing people who were suffering, right? So after seeing, the statue started crying. Ki duniya mein to itna dukh hai, there is so much social injustice. And I did not know it when I was alive. I was not even aware ki kisi ko khana nahi mil rahe. Some people are dying to get work. There are people, a mother is just single-handedly feeding the baby and she's not having the food. The other one, a child is working, you know, and this is the reality of society. So he thought that when I was a prince, I did not know. But after my death, as a statue, I witnessed that there are many, you can say, strata of those society, our society, which are not even getting basic amenities. So social injustice, poverty, and we will be, you know, getting the values of being kind, and we should learn the feeling of empathy towards others. Clear? So let's continue. I will be sharing the screen now. We were on page 29. This is page 29 only. Let's continue. Prepare to go to sleep. Everybody is having book? Anyone without book today? Nahi hai? But you cannot share it with others. But you have to listen very carefully, okay? So kindly, do not miss this, beta. Yes, page 29. So we have read when that a swallow bird. The main characters are Happy Prince, the statue of Happy Prince, and Swallow Bird. Clear? So when that bird comes and he takes shelter in the, you can say, between the feet of that statue, and he thought, I will be going tomorrow and let me take rest for night. And then suddenly few droplets of tears fell on this bird, and then he realizes the statue was crying, and statue started narrating his story. When bird asked, I'm going to read it, who are you? Who are you? He said, I'm the Happy Prince. Why are you weeping then? Asked the swallow. You have quite drenched me when I was alive and had a human heart, answered the statue. I didn't know what tears were, for I lived in the palace where sorrow is not allowed to enter. My courtiers called me the Happy Prince, and happy indeed I was. So I lived and so I died. Means I lived even happily, I died happily. Throughout my life, I did not have any worry. And now that I am dead, they have set me up here so high that I can see the ugliness and all the misery. Misery means dukh of all my city people. And though my heart is made of lead, yet I cannot choose but weep. Lead is a material. He's saying, I do not have a human heart. I cannot do anything. Fine, I'm helpless because I'm a statue. But I want someone to help me. I'm just crying because I cannot do anything for these people. What? Is he not solid gold? Said the swallow to himself. So swallow thought, the whole statue is made up of gold and heart of the statue is made up of lead only. He was too polite to make any personal remarks. Yes, beta, you can go there. The desk is empty over there. Ashna, you get up. You go there. Fine, Gia, you get up. One, you can skip. You also, beta, you can skip. Means make sure if you have facility, skip the desk. Fine, this is what sir has also asked. Last. Gia, third last. And you here. Fine. So this way, distance can be maintained. Fine. So then what happened? What? Is he not solid gold? So swallow thought. A gold statue, but heart is of not pure gold. Far away, continued the statue in a low musical voice. Far away in little street, there is a poor house. Now, beta, what is going to happen? Yes, beta, please pay attention. This statue is going to narrate various incidents that how people in his town are suffering and he never knew. Clear? वो बताने लगा है फर्स्ट स्टोरी नंबर वन डाल लो यहाँ पे यू शुड नो ऑल दैट फार अवे इन अ लिटिल स्ट्रीट देयर इज अ पुअर हाउस वन ऑफ द विंडोज इज ओपन एंड थ्रू इट आई कैन सी अ वुमन सीटेड एट द टेबल हर फेस इज थिन एंड वॉन एंड शी हैज कोर्स रेड हैंड्स ऑल प्रिक्ड बाय द नीडल फॉर शी इज अ सीमस्ट्रेस She is embroidering flowers on a satin gown for the loveliest of the queen's maids of honor to wear at the next court ball. What is a ball? Ball is a party. It's not ball. Fine, court ball you might have seen, you know, in fairy tales, how prince and princesses wearing gowns and suits, they're dancing. That is called a ball only. Fine, official gathering of royal people. So, what is there? He's saying, statue is telling that from one of the open window, I saw that there is one lady who's a seamstress. Seamstress is, she keeps on using the needle to weave beautiful flowers on beautiful gowns or dresses banati hai. And her hand is pricked with needle. Her hand is turned red. Fine. And she's continuously working without any break. And after that, in a bed, in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill. This lady has to continuously work and her son is very ill. He is in one of the bed nearby. He has a fever and he is asking his mother to give him oranges. His mother has nothing to give him but river water. So he is crying. So what is the pathetic condition of this woman who is continuously working? But she does not have money so that she can buy fruits for her ill son, sick son. Fine. He's crying like anything, but she has nothing to give it to him and only river water. Swallow, swallow, little swallow. Will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword head? So this is the first request made by the statue. The dear swallow, little swallow, can you take this ruby out of my sword and give it to that woman? My feet are fastened to this pedestal. I cannot move because I'm a statue. I cannot move. My feet are fixed at a pedestal. So that's why I have to be here only. So you will help me, little swallow. You have to help me. Next page, beta. This is page number 30. I'm waited for in Egypt. Said the swallow. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flowers. Soon they will go to sleep. This is the answer given by the swallow bird. Swallow bird says, statue, I am going to Egypt. You know, I told you about the migratory birds. All of his friends have flown. They have gone to Egypt and only this little swallow is left. So he's saying, my friends are there and they are waiting for me in Egypt. My friends are flying up and down the Nile. Nile is the name of a river. Fine. And they are all talking to the large lotus flowers. They all will sleep. They are waiting for me. Let me go. The prince asked the swallow to stay with him for one night. So prince requested him, dear swallow, little swallow, please wait. Just for a night and be my messenger. The boy is so thirsty and the mother so sad. He said, I don't think I like boys, answered the swallow. I want to go to Egypt. That swallow was adamant. He did not listen to the statue. He says, I don't like boys. I don't want to stay here. I want to go. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. It is very cold here, he said. But he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. So swallow bird said, okay, though it is very cold here and I wanted to go to Egypt, but let's wait. I'll be messenger for a night only. And tomorrow morning, I will fly away. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. The swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. He passed by the cathedral tower where the white marble angels were sculptured. Cathedral tower is the church. Fine. And pictures of angels could be seen, which were gilded on the marble. He passed by the palace and heard the sound of dancing. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover. I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball, she said. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy. See the reality of life. I told you this is social injustice. When that bird was flying, fine, he overheard one conversation. Usme suni jaate jaate conversation. That one girl, she was talking to her lover and she was telling that I want to attend that ball party and I have given one of my gowns and flowers to be embroidered. And who is doing the embroidery? That old woman whose son is sick. Fine. And she said that these seamstresses, inke paas time hi nahi hai, and they are not able to, you know, make our dresses. We start judging others. Without even thinking ki uski life mein kya chal raha hai. This is our reality. So that girl was not bothered about life of seamstress. She was interested in her dress only. Then what happened? He passed over the river and saw the lanterns hanging on the masts of the ships. At last he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. He kaun hai yahan pe? Swallow bird. The boy was tossing feverishly on his bed. And the mother had fallen asleep. She was so tired. So when that swallow bird reached the house of that poor lady, she was dead tired. She was sleeping on her desk only. And the boy was tossing over. He was not able to sleep. Kabhi left ho raha hai, kabhi right ho raha hai, because he was having fever. He was not well. And he was hungry also. And mother had fallen asleep. In he hopped and laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. Thimble is that machine where she was weaving that flower, fine, where she was working. Then he flew gently round the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. What he did? Swallow bird also felt bad for the little boy. He started giving wind to that little boy. Itni garmi thi usne, means the boy was feeling feverish. So as a gesture of love, he fanned his wings over the boy, and then after that he flew away. And boy said, how cool I feel, I must be getting better. And he sank into a delicious slumber. Slumber here means beta, deep sleep. Slumber means deep sleep. When you do not know what is happening around you, you are in deep sleep. So after getting fanned by that bird, that boy went into deep slumber. Then the swallow flew back to Happy Prince and told him what he had done. It is curious, he remarked, but I feel quite warm now. Although it is so cold, that is because you have done a good action, said the prince. And the little swallow began to think and then fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. When day broke, he flew down to the river and had a bath. Tonight I go to Egypt, said the swallow, and he was in high spirits at the prospect. You know, when we do good deeds, actually we become very happy. After helping someone, you start feeling the warmth of love. Fine. वैसे आप कुछ नहीं करते हो, you don't feel any feeling. But when you actually help someone, a poor lady, a poor person, and then you feel a satisfaction, ki, okay, I have helped someone. So that swallow bird was happy and he thought, okay, for one day I have helped someone. Now I will be moving to Egypt. Page number 31, you can see the picture of that seamstress, how she was weaving flowers, she was sleeping on her table only, and boy was there and swallow bird flew away. Clear? Then he visited all the monuments and sat a long time on the top of church steeple. When the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Have you any commissions for Egypt? He cried, I'm just starting. So that bird went to statue and told him that, happy prince, I'm going back to Egypt. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, will you stay with me one night longer? It means happy prince still wanted to help someone, right? So he asked for help. Far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. He's leaning over a desk covered with papers. And in the glass by his side, there is a bunch of withered violets. His hair is brown and crisp, and his lips are red as a pomegranate. He has large and dreamy eyes. He's trying to finish a play for the director of the theater. But he's too cold to write anymore. There is no fire in the grate, and hunger has made him faint. So Happy Prince says, my dear bird, I saw, rather than, you know, saying, yes, okay, you can go. He did not listen to Swallow Bird. And he told him that there is one young, one writer. He writes plays and stories for directors. And he's sitting in his room and it is very cold there. Fine. Very cold. And he does not have any fireplace in his room. And he does not have any food. So out of hunger, he has fainted. Wo behosh hai. So I want your help. I will wait with you one night longer, said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. Alas, I have no ruby now, said the prince. So he said, do you want me to give one more ruby? So he says, no, I don't have another ruby. My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphires, precious stones. Next page, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. So that statue tells that my sapphires in the eyes are very precious stones. Thousands of years ago, it was brought from India. He ordered the swallow. He ordered the swallow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. Playwright, beta, playwriter ko hi bolte hai. W-R-I-G-H-T. Agar aap play writer likhoge, that will be W-R-I-T-E-R. Or play right likhoge, one and same thing. He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play, he said. Dear prince, said the swallow, I cannot do that. And he began to weep. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So the swallow plucked out the prince's eye. Why? This bird cried here. He agreed to his command, ki, okay, I will help that playwright, but he started crying. Why? Because he's going to pluck his eyes. Statue will not be able to see them. Statue is able to see to the people, na? That problems of people he's able to see. But when his eyes will be plucked out, he will be blind. So that's why Swallow started crying by seeing the generosity or kindness. Fine, here our values are evoking. Sari values kaun se? Kindness, empathy, sympathy. So even then, as per his command, he plugged out his one eye and he just started flying. It is, so the swallow plugged out the prince's eye and flew away to the young man's garret. Garret is a very small room. It was easy enough to get in as there was a hole in the roof. It was so poor. There was a hole in the roof. Through this, he darted and came into the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up and he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. Violets are the flowers, beta. So that man, when he woke up, he rested his head in his hands. So he was sitting like that, so he could not realize. Jaise usne muh upar kiya, he could see a sapphire on his table. I am beginning to be appreciated, he cried. This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play. And he looked quite happy. वो कहते हैं पक्का ही कोई मेरा फैन होएगा जिसको अच्छा लगता होएगा मेरा राइटिंग. Finally, somebody is there who admires me, who loves me. Now I will finish my play. He was so happy after getting that sapphire. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of a large vessel and watched the sailors working. I am going to Egypt, cried the swallow, but nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Agar swallow bird ko jana hota, fly away to Egypt, to chala jata. Why is coming back again and again to tell the, you remember in the beginning he said, no, I want help. Maine nahi help karni hai. I don't like boys. Yaad hai? It means if you are in the company of kind people and if you see the, you know, sorrows of others, it can transform you. Swallow bird was totally transformed now. He wanted to fly back to his friends who were waiting in Egypt, but he did not go. Wo bar bar happy prince ke paas kyun aa raha hai? Because rather he is saying no to help, but actually he is also ready to help others. Fine? That's why he is coming back. Otherwise he might have flown. So again he said, I have come to bid you goodbye. He cried. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince. Will you not stay with me one night longer? It is winter, answered the swallow, and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt, the sun is warm on the green palm trees, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them. In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. Number three, beta. Third incident now. Incident of match girl. You can get any incident. Incident of poor woman, seamstress. Second was playwright. Third was match girl. You should know all the incidents. Objective questions will be there. Fine, in your test. So there stands a little match girl. A choti si bachi, matches. You know that she was selling those matchboxes. She has let her matches fall in the gutter and they are all spoiled. Choti si bachi, she was selling matchboxes and that matches fell into the gutter accidentally. She was crying there and they are all spoiled. Sab kharab ho gaya. And her father will beat her if she does not bring home some money. She belonged to such poor family that she had to give some money to her father daily. And she will be beaten up if she will not give any money. She's crying. She has no shoes or no stockings. Itni thand hai, but she's not wearing any socks or shoes. Her little head is bare. Sir pe koi cap bhi nahi hai itni thand mein. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her and her father will not beat her. So, Sechu requested the swallow bird to give the second eye, second sapphire, precious stone to that little girl. I will stay with you one night longer, said the swallow, but I cannot pluck out your eye. You would be quite blind then. So, swallow says, I want to help you, but I cannot take your eye out. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. It is my command. This is my order. Please pluck my eye. So he plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down with it. He swooped past the match girl and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. Uske hand pe fank deta hai wo bird. What a lovely bit of glass, cried the little girl. She ran home laughing. Then the swallow came back to the prince. You are blind now, he said. So I will stay with you always. No, little swallow, said the poor prince. You must go away to Egypt. This is the bitter true generosity, true love. They do not know each other, that bird and statue. But after seeing that how he helps others, and now he has become blind, how he will see the sufferings of others, how he will help others. So this swallow bird decided to stay with him. But that prince is saying, no, little swallow, you must go to Egypt because it is very cold here. You will die. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow. He slept at the prince's feet. All the next day, he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in the strange lands. So that swallow bird actually became the eyes of statue, fine? So he started narrating stories. He, okay, statue, I'm seeing this, I'm seeing that. Dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there. So he says, I don't want to listen to the stories. I want to know about the sorrows of others. You go and take a round. Okay, the swallow bird, take a round of the whole city and tell me, what do you see? So the swallow bird flew over the great city and he saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses. Kya dekhte? Social injustice. Rich people enjoying in their houses, beautiful houses. Beggars were sitting at the gates. He flew into dark lanes. He saw white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. Ek taraf bache bhooke mar rahe hain. Under the archway of a bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms. See, what a condition. Two brothers holding each other and crying. Fine, we'll continue tomorrow. The question answers better, kindly, you have to see.